Hello everyone, myself Dr. M.SRUJAN Kumar Reddy. My education background is pharmacy. We have been dealing with a topic called as suppositories and pessaries. We have completed with two sessions. In order to listen to my previous sessions, please subscribe to my channel. Today's session, we are going to deal with a topic called as displacement value and calculation. Before going directly into the topic, I want to narrate a small story here. You might have come across during your childhood. You can see some images displayed here. The story is all about a pot and crow. So once upon a time, there was a crow which was thirsty and it was searching for water. Fortunately, it has found a pot containing water, and crow felt very happy. When that crow approached the pot, there is a difficulty here. The pot was not filled completely with water. There is some water at the bottom of the pot. As crow couldn't reach the bottom of the pot, so it was very much depressed, and that crow doesn't want to give up. So crow started thinking. So the crow got an idea, and the idea was to pelt stones into the pot. And slowly crow has taken one stone and started dropping into the pot. Slowly, when the crow started dropping the stones, the water started rising from the top. As many stones the crow dropped into the pot, the water has been risen to the top of the pot. Then happily, crow drank water and it has left away. So here, what is the moral of the story? If there is a will, there is a way. Where everyone knows this story. Everyone knows the moral, but people forgot what is the physics that is behind this rising of water. Nobody questioned here. So really there is a physics behind this. The physics is nothing but the concept involved here is displacement. The stone has displaced the water, thereby the water started rising. So you can see in the fourth image, there are many stones and you can see the water has been risen to the top of the top. That means this many stones have displaced the water that is present at the bottom. So the concept involved here is displacement concept. Now, in what way the displacement value is important for the formulation of suppository? What do you mean by the term displacement value? Displacement value is defined as quantity of drug which displaces 1 gram of the base. What do you mean by displacement value? The quantity of drug which displaces 1 gram of the base. So what it is? Let me explain you. I hope everyone are aware of suppository moles. Each suppository mole will be having a specific weight. So there are some 1 gram moles, 2 gram moles, 4 gram moles or 8 gram moles. So for example, consider there is a suppository mole of 1 gram capacity. Now for that 1 gram, if you can see any Rx, I will show the examples further. Okay, if you take any Rx for the formulation of suppository, that particular Rx will contain base that is equal to take base quantity of 1 gram and an API quantity of X grams. It might be 200 mg or 300 mg or 400 mg, X grams. That means 1 gram is the weight of the base. And 400 mg, if you can consider as an example, 400 mg is the weight of an API. So total it is 1.4 gram. But the capacity of the mold is 1 gram. So here there is a need of some calculation. That calculation is nothing but displacement value calculation. How much amount of cocoa butter is required to displace that API? What it is? How much amount of the cocoa butter is required to displace the API in order to make it to 1 gram? This is what we need to calculate. Did you got my point here? The capacity of the mold is 1 gram here. But when you see the formula, it is 1.4 gram. So how much amount of the cocoa butter can be reduced to compensate the base in order to prepare 1 gram of total weight of your suppository? This is the concept we need to know. So there are some steps involved in order to calculate the displacement value. These steps are mainly meant for calculation of displacement value of API. These steps are meant for calculation of displacement value of API. Okay, here we are not calculating how much amount of base is required to compensate. Here we are calculating, when you say displacement value, in calculation we need to know what is the displacement value for a API. So in order to calculate displacement value for an API, here there are some steps. Six steps are there. First step, theoretical value of total base required is designated as capital A. Okay, theoretical weight of total drug required, it is designated as capital B. Theoretical weight of total suppository, when you say total suppository, that is nothing but API plus base, that is nothing but A plus B, is designated as C. Fourth step, practical weight of total suppository. What would be the practical? When you say practical weight of total suppository, it is nothing but after calculating the total compensation of cocoa butter to be added to the formulation, that is nothing but practical weight of total suppository. That is designated as capital D. Difference in weights, that is nothing but C minus D. What is the difference in weights? C minus D. That is designated as E. So difference in weights, C is nothing but theoretical weight of total suppository, and D is nothing but practical weight of total suppository. It is designated as E. Next, displacement value. How to calculate displacement value? That is equal to B by E. What is B here? Theoretical weight of total drug required. What is the total drug required? That is the theoretical weight. That is designated as B by E. Difference in weights is nothing but E. So by this you can calculate the displacement value. This particular six steps can be easily explained with the help of an example, then you can understand. Now we will deal with an example. If a prescription requires 400 mg of bismuth subgallate per suppository, what is the weight of API per suppository? 400 mg. Weighing about 2 gram, what would be the displacement value if it is known that 6 suppositories with required bismuth subgallate weighing about 13.6 gram. This is your question. Yeah, what are the things that can be considered from the question? First thing, what is the weight of API in your suppository? 400 mg. Okay, each suppository weight is 400 mg. Which weight? API weight. That means API is nothing but bismuth subgallate. Okay, next. What is the weight of suppository to be prepared? 2 grams. Okay. Next. How many suppositories to be prepared? 6 suppositories. What is the total practical weight of all the suppositories? It is 13.6 grams. These four things. First one, weight of API per suppository is 400 mg. Okay. And what is the weight of suppository? 2 grams. And how many suppositories to be prepared? 6. And what is the practical weight of total suppositories? 13.6 grams. Let us apply the steps here. The first step, theoretical weight of total base required. What is the theoretical weight of total base required? Per suppository, how much base should be required? 2 grams. How many suppositories to be prepared? 6 suppositories. So total base is equal to, you can see below, 6 number of suppositories into each suppository containing about how much base? 2 grams. 6 into 2. So 12 grams. Clear? Next, second point. Theoretical weight of total drug required. Okay, the second point is theoretical weight of total drug required. Per suppository, what is the weight? 400 mg. For 6 suppository, how much? 6 into 400. How much? 2.4 gram. Second step is over. Now, theoretical weight of total suppository is nothing but A plus B. So, A is 12 grams and B is 2.4 gram. So, theoretical weight of total suppository, third point mark. 12 plus 2.4. How much? 14.4 gram. Next, practical weight of total suppositories. What, as I told you in the question, what is the practical weight of total suppositories? It is 13.6 gram. So, practical weight of total suppository, can you see below? 13.6 grams. Next, difference in weights. Difference in weights is nothing but C minus D. So, here 14.4 minus 13.6. C minus D. Okay. So, it will give you 0.8 grams. Difference in weights is 0.8 grams. What is the fifth one? Directly the formula. Displacement value is equal to B by E. What is B? Theoretical weight of total drug required. How much we have got here? Theoretical weight of total drug 2.4 divided by difference in weights. How much value? 0.8. 2.4 divided by 0.8. That is equal to 3. The displacement value of bismuth subgality is 3. Here, this is the table containing individual displacement values. Okay, if you can see bismuth gallate, the displacement value is 2.5. We have got how much? 3. Just 2.5 can be rounded up to 3. Okay, this is an example mark. Okay, next example. If 12 theobromo oil suppositories containing 40% zinc oxide weighing about 17.6 grams, what is the displacement value of zinc oxide? Assume that suppositories are made in 1 gram gold, 1 gram mold. So, what we can understand from this question? What are the things to be considered here? So, how many suppositories to be prepared? 12 suppositories, first thing. Okay. And what is the total practical weight of total suppositories? It is 17.6 grams, second thing. And what is the weight of each suppository? 1 gram. Okay. Third. And fourth one, what is the amount of drug present? What is the amount of drug present? That is nothing but weight of your API. So, here the weight of your API has been not given directly. It has been given in 40%. That is nothing. How much percentage given? 40%. How to solve this? The same steps to be applied. There is a little tricky here. Conversion of your percentage to weight or amount to be done. How? First thing. Theoretical weight of total base required. So, what is the, how many suppositories to be prepared? 12 suppository. What is the mold weight? 1 gram. So, total base is equal to 12 into 1. How many grams? 12 grams. Done? Yeah. Second, theoretical weight of total drug required. Theoretical weight of total drug required. So, as I said, it is given in 40%. 40% in always percentage should be confined to the 100. Okay. So, 40 divided by 100 into what is the total weight of suppository practical weight? 17.6. So, 40 divided by 100 into 17.6 will give you a weight about 7.04 gram. So, 7.04 grams present for 12 suppositories. So, this 7.04 gram present for one suppository, if you want to calculate the weight of APA for one suppository, that is nothing but 7.04 divided by 12 will give you a value about 0.587 gram. So, 0.587 gram is the weight of API per suppository. For 7 suppositories, 0.587 into 12, it will give you a value about 7.04. Are you clear? This is about step B. And step C, obviously, ma, what is a theoretical value of total suppository? So, A plus B. What is the total weight of your base? 12 grams. What is the weight of API? 7.04. 12 plus 7.04, 19.04 gram. Next, practical weight of total suppositories has been given in the question. 17.6 gram. And what is the difference in weights? Same, 19.04 minus 17.6 will give you a weight about 1.44 gram. What is the displacement value? The displacement value is equal to B by E. What is B here? Total theoretical weight of total drug required. The value is how much you have got? 7.04 divided by difference in weights. How much? 1.44. That gives you a value about 4.89 grams. This is second example. Okay. Are you clear? Yeah. The two examples in the previous slides are meant for calculating displacement value of medicament present in the formulation or displacement value of API present in the formulation. Now the present example is meant for calculating how much amount of cocoa butter to be added for revised formula. Okay, so here there is an RX, boric acid 120 mg, cocoa butter as 1 gram. Okay, and here the suppositories to be sent, 8 suppositories to be sent, and displacement value of boric acid already it has been given as 1.5. So what you need to do here, if you can remember the first slide, what I told you, the capacity of the suppository mold is 1 gram, if it is 1 gram. So here if you can see the RX, the base itself is 1 gram and your API weight is 120 mg. That means 0.12 gram. That is around 1.1 gram. Total it is about 1.1 gram. But the capacity of your mold is how much? 1 gram. So how you are going to fit this 1.1 into 1 gram suppository mold? It is difficult. So here you need to apply something called as displacement value and calculation. So here the concept, what to be displaced here? You need to displace your cocoa butter for boric acid. So that should be done here. So how to do that? Here there is a solution. So how many suppositories to be sent here? 8. So always remember, for the preparation of powders, for the preparation of suppositories, for the preparation of tablets or any type of dosage form, always you need to calculate one or two extra to compensate the loss based upon the type of dosage form. Some dosage form will take one extra, some dosage forms will take two extra, some dosage forms will take 10 extra also. It depends upon the type of dosage form. Why we need to calculate extra weight, you know, the main reason is to compensate the loss during formulation. In order to compensate the loss during formulation. So here, as a formulator is asking you to send 8, so we will calculate 2 extra. 8 plus 2, that is nothing but 10 suppositories. So the boric acid per suppository is 120 mg. For 10, that is nothing but 120 into 10, that will give you around 1.2 gram. So how much cocoa butter to be taken? Cocoa butter per suppository is 1 gram. So 1 gram into 10, that is around 10 grams. Okay. The displacement value of boric acid given as 1.5. Now my question is, how much gram of boric acid displaces how much gram of cocoa butter? So how many grams of boric acid we have here? 1.2 grams of boric acid is there. Okay, and we have got the displacement value of boric acid also. So in order to calculate this, the formula here it is, total quantity of API, total quantity of API divided by displacement value. Total quantity of API, what is the total weight of API here? It is 1.2 gram for 10 suppositories divided by 1.5, that will give you 0.8 grams of cocoa butter. That will give you 0.8 grams of cocoa butter should be displaced. So therefore, quantity of cocoa butter required, that is nothing but total quantity of cocoa butter minus your displaced value of cocoa butter, that is nothing but 0.8. So 10 minus 0.8, it is around 9.2 gram. So the revised formula for the preparation of suppository is, boric acid 1.2 grams we have to take, cocoa butter we have to take the quantity of 9.2 grams. How many suppositories? For 10 suppositories. For 10 suppositories. This is the revised formula. So any form letter who ask you to prepare this many number of suppositories by giving an Rx, always you need to consider the displacement value calculations. Okay, is it clear? Yeah. Next. That's all about today's presentation. Thank you very much.